morning, everyone. I'm Cadet Lieutenant Colonel Dakota Parent, Battalion Commander of the Raider JRTC program. Our JRTC Color Guard members will soon present our colors. The Color Guard cadet members are Second Lieutenant Alexander Bell, Cadet Master Sergeant Jason Krozik, Cadet Second Lieutenant Samantha Ruth, and Cadet Major Bailey Medea. The presentation of our colors will be followed by the Pledge of Allegiance and then the National Anthem. Finally, we will have an invocation by two of our seniors. Please rise for the presentation of the colors. Please join me in saying the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good evening. I am Nathan Morris.
And I am Cease Nunez.
We are proud seniors at Crescent City High School. Tonight we will be presenting the graduation prayer in English and Spanish. Please join me in a word of prayer.
Buenas tardes. Somos
Nathan Morris
y Cease Nunez. Somos unos orgullosos seniors de Crescent City High School. Por favor, únanse conmigo para una oración.
Please close your eyes and bow your heads.
Inclinen sus rostros.
Heavenly Father, thank you for the opportunity to assemble here today, as it is a great blessing from you. We pray for safety in our community tonight throughout this ceremony and the health of those here tonight.
Padre Celestial, gracias por la oportunidad que nos das de reunirnos hoy, ya que es una gran bendición tuya. Oramos por la seguridad de nuestra comunidad esta noche a lo largo de esta ceremonia y la salud de los que están aquí esta noche.
We just ask, Lord, for you to open the hearts and minds of our graduating class as well as everyone here gathered tonight for what is being offered. We pray that you surround those of us who are graduating with your grace.
Solo te pedimos, Señor, que abras los corazones y las mentes de nuestra clase de graduados, así como a todos los que están aquí reunidos esta noche para lo que se ofrece. Oramos para que rodees a aquellos de nosotros que nos graduamos con tu gracia.
Bless us with hope so that we move into our futures with eager and open hearts. Help us put the knowledge, skills, and insights gained throughout our education to use for the good of all humankind. Inspire us to believe in the goodness of life, even when faced with challenges and difficulties. As we commence with our lives, let us grow ever more wise and grateful.
Bendícenos con esperanza para avanzar hacia nuestro futuro con corazones ansiosos y abiertos. Ayúdanos a utilizar el conocimiento, las habilidades y los conocimientos adquiridos a través de nuestra educación para el bien de toda la humanidad. Inspíranos a creer en la bondad de la vida, incluso cuando enfrentemos desafíos y dificultades. A medida que comenzamos con nuestras vidas, haznos cada vez más sabios y agradecidos.
Thank you for your love this special evening and all the students who are assembled here. May each and every one of us feel a sense of achievement and great excitement about our futures. May each one of us know your presence in our lives and understand how to use our abilities for the kingdom and glory. May all of us continue to enjoy lives of learning and discover, and in doing so, bring great blessings to this world. We pray that you watch over this class and their families and their travels, Lord, not only tonight, but from this day on. We pray in Christ's name.
Gracias por tu amor esta noche especial y todos los estudiantes que están reunidos aquí. Todos y cada uno de nosotros tengamos una sensación de logro y gran entusiasmo por nuestro futuro. Que cada uno de nosotros conozca tu presencia en nuestras vidas y comprenda cómo usar nuestras habilidades para tu reino y gloria. Que todos podamos seguir disfrutando de vidas de aprendizaje y descubrimiento y al hacerlo traer grandes bendiciones a este mundo. Oramos para que velas por esta clase y sus familias en sus viajes. Señor, no solo esta noche, sino a partir de este día.
Thank you. You may be seated.
Gracias. Pueden tomar asiento.
Well, good evening, everyone. I just wanted to say first thank you to Mrs. Jones and our supporting band for the ceremony this year and for many, many years that I've been here at Crescent City High School. It's such a wonderful accompaniment. Thank you, ma'am. Well, welcome everyone to Crescent City High School's Class of 2021 graduation ceremony. I'm Dr. John Shelby, principal at Crescent City High School, and I'm very pleased and honored to lead this high school because of these 132 students sitting in front of me who have successfully earned their way here tonight, and we're so proud of them. Let's give them another round of applause for being the Class of 2021. Please allow me for a moment to share our vision and mission statements with you. Our vision states, Crescent City High School will empower our learning community for opportunities after graduation. Our mission states, in partnership with the community, Crescent City High School will prepare students for life after graduation through a challenging curriculum, industry-aligned experiences, and a culture that supports personalized learning. As we journey through tonight's ceremony, just remember, I want all of you to see how we are fulfilling that vision and mission here at Crescent City High School in the Raider Nation. For starters, the class of 2021 tonight has the highest graduation rate since we began counting through the federal graduation rate system, and that calculation measure now shows that 94% of our seniors have graduated on time. Also, our Cambridge students who are exiting the field tonight will have been accepted to college entrances in many different schools, both colleges, university, and technical programs, and all of them have some significant financial support, those that have achieved the Cambridge diploma. Those local scholarships are such a wonderful thing. Congratulations to all of you that continue to apply for scholarships. Give yourselves a round of applause. Now I'd like to take a few minutes and recognize several distinguished guests here tonight and members of our local community. First, on my right and behind me, Ms. Michelle Tucker, Assistant Principal at Crescent City High School. She's a strong and courageous leader, makes this school greater each and every year. Behind me, Dr. Rick Cerency, Superintendent of Putnam County Schools. From our district office, we have Ms. Laura France, Assistant Superintendent of Curriculum Instruction. Mrs. Tanya Whitehurst, Executive Director of Human Resources. Dr. Melissa Coleman, Executive Director of Federal Programs and Instructional Acceleration. Mrs. Renee Huff, Director of Career and Technical Education. Mr. Andy Burnett, Director of Exceptional Student Education. Over to my left, we have Ms. Sarah Jean McDaniel, Executive Director of Leadership and Development. New title, by the way. Ms. Ashley McCool, Director of Community Relations. Joining us tonight also from Middleton Burney Elementary School is the Assistant Principal, Ms. Yolanda Brady, who I look forward to working alongside very, very soon, folks. We are welcomed tonight, my friend, colleague, and incoming principal of Crescent City Junior Senior High School, Mr. Tim Adams. Now from your Raider Nation and Chair of the Putnam County School District, Ms. Holly Pickens. Most of you know Coach Holly Pickens. Also, school board members, Mr. David Buckles, unable to join us tonight, but we know her presence is here. She's probably watching online. Ms. Jane Crawford. Ms. Sandra Gilliard. And Mr. David Buckles. Excuse me, Bud McInnes. Without the support and education and the dedication of our district leadership, our school board members tonight would not be making it possible had they not had the compassion for all of our South Putnam students. They make everything happen in our school system. Because of their support, we are able to provide the most wonderful educational opportunities for all of our students, grades K through 12. We are blessed to have Mr. Bill Pickens with us tonight, our Putnam County Commissioner. And also Pastor Daniel Jones, who is a pastor of South Putnam Church, who we partner with. And he continues to support our community throughout the year, as well as our annual baccalaureate ceremony. Over to my right, you'll see the faculty and staff, the ones that make everything possible throughout our school district, especially here in South Putnam Schools. These are wonderful educators that dedicate their lives to educating children and raising them up so that they have a future beyond high school. Let's give them a big round of applause, everyone. Among us on the field and in the stands are many distinguished individuals as well. First, I want to recognize the veterans of our United States Armed Forces. Would you please stand as we celebrate your service to our country? Thank you. Let us also recognize those among us who are currently serving or have served as members in the medical field, law enforcement, and emergency services. Without you, our schools would not be safe, nor would our community each and every day. Thank you. Tonight, I feel it's necessary to recognize two members of the Raider Nation who are no longer with us. Over to my right, there's a faculty robe draped across one of the empty chairs and a photograph recognizing Coach Stacy Cook, who passed away back on December 1st of 2020. Many of these students here tonight on the field were taught, mentored, and coached by Mr. Cook for many, many years. We will forever miss his presence at Crescent City High School. Thank you, Coach Cook. Also, we have a cap and gown draped over an empty chair to my right facing the audience. This is to recognize Leslie Vasquez, who lost her life tragically in a car accident back on December 1st of 2020. Leslie had already met the criteria to graduate with her Cambridge diploma, so tonight we'll recognize her later in our ceremony. Now I'd like to recognize our outstanding junior ambassadors who helped us serve this event and previous events for our seniors. These individuals had some of the highest weighted GPAs in their class. They are Melanie DeLeon, Reagan Grimes, Stephanie Guerrero, Maria Lugo Garcia, Eliana Ramirez, Maya Schaefer, and Faith Thomas. Please stand and be recognized. We look forward to the great things you'll be doing your senior year. Now I promise I always save the best for last. We are surrounded by the parents and guardians of these wonderful students here on the field, their grandparents, extended family members, and former graduates as well. Because of your support over the last 18 years of their lives, our students are here tonight because of you. Students, let's give a big greater shout out to all of our families. Thank you. At this time, I'd like to call to the podium Dr. Rick Cerency, Superintendent of the Putnam County School District.
Thank you, Dr. Shelby. I'd like to take a minute just to welcome the class of 2021. It's been a tough year, and you've hung in there and persevered. Again, thanks to all the families, the friends, faculty, and staff, and a special thank you to the administrators, Ms. Tucker, and especially Dr. Shelby, who's been a principal here for 4 years, who will be changing assignments after tonight. Will be at Middleton Burney Elementary, and as he said, Tim Adams will be the new principal here. But I want to thank Dr. Shelby and Ms. Tucker for their outstanding leadership during this most difficult year. So let's give them a round of applause, please. It is so great to be face-to-face for a change after such a horrific year, but we made it, and I just want to share a few brief comments as a source of inspiration and encouragement before you get your diplomas tonight. I want to tell you a short story about space travel. In 1970, a year after we landed a man on the moon, after the Apollo 11 mission, Apollo 13 was launched again to land Americans on the moon. As the astronauts were well on their path to the moon, something terribly happened. An oxygen tank exploded and would put the three-man crew in danger of not reaching the moon, and even worse yet, not being able to return back to Earth. You probably remember, if you saw the movie, the famous radio transmission, "Houston, we have a problem." And you remember what happened. The NASA ground crew began to work on assembling the same items that the Apollo 13 crew had on the ship to come up with a plan to repair the damaged tank so the crew could safely return to Earth. Armed with only the items that were available to the astronauts, the ground crew came up with an answer to the problem by using a number of simple items, one being duct tape, to repair the damage. The mission was saved, and the crew returned to Earth safely. I use this story to encourage each of you to remember there is always an answer. There's always an answer to the problems that may confront you in the future. It's about creating options that might result in finding the ultimate answer. Just as the ground crew and the astronauts of Apollo 13 worked together, we must work together with others to collaborate in solving problems. When we think about the word collaboration, I like to use the analogy of the roots on a giant redwood tree that are found in the forests of Northern California. The roots do not run very deep. As a matter of fact, they grow outward. You would think the trees, some between 200 and 300 feet high, would fall over with such a shallow root system. However, they stand together strong, and the key to their survival is they interlock their roots with other redwood trees, trying to become more stable and withstand the winds that might cause them to blow down. Beginning this fall, the community of Crescent City will lock root systems together as we unite Miller Middle School and Crescent City High School into the new grades 7 through 12 Crescent City Junior Senior High School. Middleton Burney Elementary School will become a new kindergarten to sixth grade school. The consolidation of these schools will provide many, many opportunities for collaboration in this great community. Over the past 3 years, the school district has celebrated the Putnam County graduates who have chosen to live and work in Putnam County and give back through their careers and through their service. The recipients are selected from the areas of agriculture, education, industrial manufacturing, community service, business, healthcare, and public service. It's no surprise that our recipient in the area of public service is a 1996 graduate of Crescent City Junior Senior High School. Please help me to congratulate Ms. Trenisha Austin, product of Putnam 2021. I know everyone's proud of Trenisha. Thank you, Trenisha. Trenisha is a dedicated public servant who has selflessly served as deputy clerk at the clerk's office for the past 22 years. In addition to a career dedicated to public service, she's an active member with Epicure, working multiple times a week and extremely active in the South Putnam community. When asked to describe Trenisha, a fellow community member stated, quote, "She is a perfect example of someone who believes in service above self to ensure this community is one we are proud to call home. Many people resort to other places, but she was born and raised in Putnam and continues to give back to the place she calls home." She wants to encourage graduates to choose a career in public service. She says you have an opportunity to earn a living wage, serve the residents of this great county, and affect positive change. Trenisha would also like to share the following words of encouragement with all of you. Quote, "An education is key in today's society. Never let anyone tell you that you can't accomplish any goals you set in life. Anything you set out to accomplish can be accomplished. Keep God first in all you do, and He will direct your way." Trenisha is an example of someone who chooses to collaborate with others in the community to make Crescent City an amazing place to live. As you move forward in your journey, graduates, I challenge you to collaborate with others and know there is always an answer to any obstacles you will face in life. Thank you and best of luck to the class of 2021.
Hey. First off, I just want to acknowledge we made it. We are now graduates after what feels like an eternity, but like also a second, it's finally here. Okay, now, before I get ahead of myself, I just want to say thank you to everybody who is here today. Thank you to our parents, guardians, cousins, aunties, uncles, siblings, friends, and everybody here. Thank you to our school staff, which includes our teachers, coaches, administrators, and custodians. And lastly, thank you to us, the graduating class of 2021. Okay. Para empezar, quiero reconocer que lo hicimos. Nos estamos graduando. Después de que hubiese parecido una eternidad, finalmente estamos aquí. Antes de continuar, quiero decir gracias por su presencia a todos ustedes y a nosotros la clase de 2021. Now, I won't lie, we have gone through so much as a class. We've literally gone through a historic pandemic, which feels never-ending, losses of our mentors and friends, rivalry between our own class, failing grades, and challenging teachers. And the list can go on. But in the end, we all get the same thing. We all graduate at the same time, the same way, with the same diploma. Everything we've been through and accomplished brings us to this moment. Even though the memories bring us back to a time of cringe or pain or embarrassment, it's good to not forget the journey that has led us here. No voy a mentir, pero hemos pasado altos y bajos como clase. Literalmente, hemos pasado por una pandemia histórica que se siente sin fin. Pérdidas de nuestros mentores y amigos, rivalidad entre nuestra propia clase, malas calificaciones, maestros desafiantes y la lista sigue. Pero al final, todos obtenemos lo mismo. Todos nos graduamos al mismo tiempo, de la misma manera, con el mismo diploma. Aunque la memoria nos regrese a momentos de dolor, bochorno y vergüenza, no debemos olvidar la jornada que nos trajo aquí. Now, what would a graduation speech be if it didn't include throwback memories? Let's remember middle school. Oh, those middle school days where side parts and trendy clothes were our things. Personally, I would like to never talk or remember those days, but at the same time, those memories are priceless. We had our teachers, from Mr. Crazy Frazy to Mr. Horsack to Mr. DeLuca and all others. We had the memory of basically being the oldest and probably the only class that was at that school for 5 years. It felt like we would never leave and go to high school. We will forever remember our middle school events, school plays where teachers participated and brought us laughter and astonishment. We will never forget Mr. Bear's rendition of Elvis Presley and Mr. Horsack's brief appearances in several plays. Drama would not have been successful without our amazing director, Mr. Hughes, the mentor we were all privileged to have. We also have the memory of reading the book, Running for My Life. Lo Pepe's biography made an impact in our life, I hope. But having met one of the characters was one of the coolest things ever. Now we can't forget our end of the year tournaments, where we prove that competition runs in our blood. We can't forget throwing pies on teachers' faces, the excitement of starting a band for the first time in decades, and participating in the yearly reading competitions with Mrs. Barty and Mrs. Bacon. Ahora, ¿qué sería un discurso de graduación sin incluir recuerdos del pasado? Recordaremos secundaria, donde los cortes de pelo y la ropa de moda eran nuestras cosas. Personalmente, me gustaría nunca hablar ni recordar esos días, pero al mismo tiempo, esos recuerdos no tienen precio. Tuvimos maestros como el señor Crazy Frazy, el señor Horsack y el señor DeLuca y otros más. Tenemos el recuerdo de ser probablemente la única clase que estuve en la escuela por 5 años. Sentí que nunca la dejaríamos. Siempre recordaremos los eventos de nuestra escuela secundaria, obras escolares donde los profesores participaron y nos trajeron risas y asombro. Nunca olvidaremos la interpretación que hizo el señor Bear de Elvis Presley y las breves apariciones del señor Horsack en varias obras de teatro. Drama no hubiera tenido éxito sin nuestro maravilloso director, el señor Hughes, el mentor que todos tuvimos el privilegio de tener. También no podemos olvidar nuestros torneos de fin del año, donde demostramos que la competencia corre en nuestra sangre. No podemos olvidar arrojar pasteles en la cara de los maestros, la emoción de comenzar una banda por la primera vez en décadas y participar en los concursos anuales de lectura. I have to admit, our class has made history at Crescent City High School. We are the first group to start and complete Cambridge. We experienced and lived through a pandemic, thank you COVID-19. We have built a tight family among students, teachers, and administration. The next time we hear Dr. Shelby, Mama Grimes, Cummings, Delaney, which one, Mrs. Holly, Alicia, Oscar, Brenner, Braddock, Bergbauer, Pilcher, Dr. Parker, Sauls, Pooh Bear, Cook, Eubanks, Tesoro, Palahads, Jones, Ross, Harden, Coach Lease, Mrs. Tucker, Short, Bell, and whoever else comes to your mind, it will for sure bring a nostalgic feeling. We were cared for and sometimes chastised, for a good reason, I guess, but at the end, we knew we were loved. Debo admitir que nuestra clase ha hecho historia en Crescent City High School. Somos el primer grupo en comenzar y completar Cambridge. Experimentamos y vivimos una pandemia. Hemos construido una familia unida entre estudiantes, maestros y administración. La próxima vez que escuchamos los nombres de la escuela, seguro te traerá un sentimiento nostálgico. Nos cuidaron y a veces nos regañaron por una buena razón, pero al final sabíamos que éramos amados. I am thankful, and I'm sure you are too, that we were able to have our homecoming week, which was literally the best. We were still able to have our grad bash, prom, and our senior skip days and pranks, even though they were susly planned, but that's okay. This year was it for us. Some of us obtained certifications as EMTs, CNAs, welding, animal and agriculture, tech, and I'm sure there are many more. Some of us will be joining the service, while others will go straight to work and make that bank. We all have different paths, as we should, but persistence, dedication, and amazing instructors made this possible. Estoy agradecida y seguramente ustedes también de que pudiéramos tener actividades normales. Algunos de nosotros obtuvimos certificaciones y otros se unieron al servicio militar. Algunos de nosotros nos iremos directamente a trabajar y empezar a ganar el sueldo. Todos tenemos caminos diferentes, pero nuestra perseverancia, dedicación y los increíbles instructores lo hicieron posible. But our high school days stops right here, right now, on this day. Crazy, right? How's it possible that in one day, June 10th, our whole world changes? Yes, of course, we expected this day to happen and have been ready for it since the first day of senior year, maybe even sooner, but I don't think we really thought about what this day really meant. No matter what road we take, the path is our own journey of discovery. To me, successes are the struggles we overcame, not where we end up. Success might have a different meaning to you, but we shouldn't compare what we might do to this day might do after this day to one another, whether we are in Cambridge or not, because we're individually creating our own success story, nobody else's. Now that I put my 2 cents in, I just want a side note that high school is nothing like High School Musical showed it to be. As we exit today, band, you better play your music and make our own High School Musical exit. Congratulations, class of 2021. We did it! And up next is Emmanuel Guerrero.
Our senior year was unlike any other. Reality doesn't hit you when you wake up for your last day at school. It doesn't hit you as you fill out the countless college applications. When springtime finally comes around and you realize that this is your last prom, but you don't feel it when you're there having the time of your life. We all begin to realize it at graduation when we look around and realize that we will never see most of our classmates again. Reality will hit over the summer when everyone gets their roommates, class schedules, and begin orientations. It still hasn't entirely hit you when you're sitting in your room packing up the past 18 years of your life or laughing with your best friend about all the stupid stuff you've done. You might feel it in the morning when you leave for college, for that will be the last time you see your room, your parents, and your childhood best friend. It will finally hit you when you're sitting in your dorm room with a stranger you have to live with for the next year or so. College might be tons of fun, but at this moment, spend as much time with your friends, for it will be not long until you meet new people and unfortunately grow apart. But graduation isn't a final goal in itself. On the contrary, it's part of a larger journey of life. Wherever your future takes you, let it guide you to something memorable. In this journey, more accomplishments will help you achieve your final goal. Our graduation should serve as a launching point, projecting us to wherever our futures are meant to take us. Whether we land ourselves a career, master of trade, continue college, or technical school education. To be successful, we must ultimately find happiness within ourselves. Most people who graduate from high school experience only one graduation, but we all have one shortly ahead of us. We've already shown our commitment to personal growth by making it to this ceremony today. Soon, all of us will experience another ceremony when we graduate from our desired programs. As I said before, life is a journey, and we shouldn't stop growing once we get our high school diplomas. Our future is about growth and opportunity and the continuance of learning new skills that we will carry with us for the rest of our lives. This achievement has shown us how capable we all are of accomplishing our goals when we put our minds to it. We must take this personal attainment as an example of how anything is truly possible. As we all continue our lives, let us take on each obstacle with confidence, knowing that we have overcome these obstacles and are equipped with necessary tools to tackle our futures. And I hope you all come back here from Crescent City 20 or 30 years from now and reflect on what you have done with your abilities and potential. I hope you will judge yourselves not on your personal accomplishments alone, but how you treated people throughout the years and how well you have addressed the world's problems. As I stand here speaking to the class of 2021, it was a pleasure to befriend most of you all. Many of y'all. Our time here comes to an end. God willingly, I look forward to meeting you all once again as fathers or mothers or even as grandparents, never forgetting the past memories we all spent with one another. And until then, may God carry you through every challenging circumstance in your adventure and give you the strength to prevail on the journey we call life. Thank you, class of 2021. Next, I present Mrs. Michelle Tucker, Assistant Principal of Crescent City High School.
Good evening. Thank you, Emmanuel. Let's take a moment now and recognize some of our distinguished graduates. Please stand as I announce your accomplishments. First, we have 9 dual enrollment students who have been working towards an Associate of Arts degree or an Associate of Science degree through St. John's River State College. Please stand. Next, our GPA recognitions are: we have greatest honor, summa cum laude, which is a GPA of 4.0 or higher. If that is you, please stand. With great honor, magna cum laude, which is a GPA of 3.75 to 3.99. If that is you, please stand. With honor, cum laude, which is a GPA of 3.5 to 3.74. If that is you, please stand. Next, we would like to recognize this year's Senior of the Month Award winners. Could we have our 10 Senior of the Month Award recipients stand, please? Next, our Career and Technical Education graduates. From the Academy of Business, students who have completed industry certification courses in Microsoft Office Suites, please stand. From the Health Science Academy, our students who have passed industry certification courses in Certified Medical Administrative Assistant, Certified Nursing Assistant, and Ready to Work, please stand. From the Industrial Academy, our students that have passed industry certification courses in welding and animal science, please stand. Congratulations to you all. I'd like to share some outstanding accomplishments from athletics and clubs this year. The varsity girls volleyball team made it to the first round of the state playoffs. Stand up, volleyball girls. The varsity boys soccer team won their district and made it to the regional semifinal game. Stand up, boys. We had one senior who was selected to the all-county football team. Where are you? Thank you, Sponge. Good job. We had two seniors who were selected to the all-county girls volleyball team. We had one senior selected to the all-county boys basketball team. We had four seniors selected to the all-county boys soccer team. We had one senior selected to the all-county girls soccer team. We had one senior selected to the all-county softball team. Two seniors were selected to the all-county baseball team, and one of those was Player of the Year. One senior was selected to the all-county boys weightlifting team and was the district champion. One senior was selected to the all-county girls weightlifting team. Our FFA chapter has four seniors that rejuvenated our school's program 3 years ago through their participation in leadership development, community outreach, public speaking, and career development in livestock. Our chapter is alive and thriving again. Please stand. The Crescent City High School Band is graduating six seniors this year, and all have completed 4 years in band. Three seniors have completed 4 years in band and 4 years in drumline, and one senior completed 4 years in band, 4 years in chorus, and 3 years in drumline. That is you, please stand. Three of our band seniors have earned the U.S. Marine Corps Semper Fidelis Award for music, excellence, and dedication. If that's you, please stand. And all six band seniors have post-secondary plans. Three members have enlisted in the Marine Corps, one was accepted to FCT to complete the welding program, and two were accepted to different universities with academic scholarships ranging from 50% to 80% of their education paid for. Congratulations. Finally, several students have signed papers to join the military. So please stand when I call your name as enlistees. Alora Finnegan. Ruben Montiel, Zamina Morales, Brandon Taylor, and Joshua Winchell have all signed with the U.S. Marine Corps. Noah Scholes signed with the U.S. Navy, and Bernice Verdugo signed with the Army National Guard. We are proud of these students who have committed to protecting all of us. And again, congratulations to all of our distinguished graduates.
Well, now we've come to that moment you've all been working so hard for over the last 13 years, the presentation of your diplomas. Teachers, please rise and form a reception line. Seniors, please wait for your rows to be called and report to the stage when called upon to receive your diploma. Ms. Balon?
At this time, we would like to recognize the family of Leslie Vasquez. With us on the field to my left is her family. Accepting a memorial diploma at this time is Leslie's brother, Anthony Vasquez. Leslie Vasquez was a bright and intelligent young woman with an ambition for success and education. She worked very hard in her Cambridge program and dedicated herself to do excellent in school and in whatever she set her mind to. Leslie will be terribly missed, but we will carry her memory through a memorial scholarship, which we will seek dedicated students just like her. Leslie Vasquez era una joven brillante e inteligente, con ambición de éxito y educación. Trabajó muy duro en el programa de Cambridge y se dedicó a sobresalir en la escuela y en todo lo que se proponía hacer. Extrañaremos muchísimo a Leslie, pero llevaremos su memoria a través de una beca conmemoratoria que buscará estudiantes dedicados como ella. Nathan Morris. Kyle Grimes. Gloria Lisette Rios. Chantel Cusco. Morgan Spencer Reeve. Vanessa Arvizu. Karina Ramirez. Isabela Ramirez. Brianna Lassane. Stacy Watson. Yair Peña. Lisbeth Espinosa. Débora Consuelos Carvajal. Esther Herrera. Berenice Verdugo. Haley Arias. Emmanuel Guerrero. Cis Maday Núñez Reina. Destiny Harper. Dakota Maria Parent. Cecilia Williams. Yasmin Fonseca. Leslie Mendez. Joshua Winchell. Rubén Montiel Martínez. Brooke Pervat. Jimena Morales. Alora Finnegan. Brandon Taylor. Alexander Johnson. Danielle Bassett. Brianna Faith Unruh. Shelby Leanne Hyers. Dalton Judd. Arabella Blanks. Angela Schifrin. Diana Lacasio. Samantha Kendall Stevens. Luis Adolfo Baltazar. Emma Blair Sledge. Haley Moore. April Billings. Jennifer Ramirez Jimenez. Woo! Veronica Ramirez. Rachel Pye. Arlie Cruz. Maria Feliz Cruz. Joel Carvajal Jr. Roger Ocampo. Juan García. Cristian Cruz. Jennifer Arriola Bautista. Anaí Rodríguez Cruz. Esteban Álvarez. Alberto Domínguez. Samuel Santana. Usías Santiago. Agustín Pérez Jr. Johnny Galván. Héctor Albarrán. Obed Pérez. Abigail Ramírez. Odalis Barrientos. Nereida Pérez. Margarita Cruz. Yahaira Alvarado. Karen Stephanie Álvarez. Ariana Solís. Morelva Barrientos. Joana Michelle González. Jacqueline Arisbel Baena. Han Anna Sharon Elam. Jacob Budavong. Daniel Perez. Pedro Sandoval. Kachanika Tappe. Jordan Williams. Sureña Aguilar. Jesús Aguirre. Ana Camacho Aguirre. Jocelyn Susé Torres. Paige Berriozíbal. Manasés Berriozábal. Xavier Vance Jr. Jordan Torres. Devin Hormsabath. Ricardo Campos. Alexis Villegas. Mario Zamora. Javier Álvarez. Trinidad Maldonado. Jaime Gómez. Chris Britt. Willie Johnson. Brian Luna. Caleb Millard. Michaela Schaefer. Heather O'Kelly. Juliet Leona Brinkley. Noah Scholes. Jaden Murray. Tyron Gaines. Tykira Ashanti Bryant. Sierra Cox. Dalton Wilkinson. Dylan Hutchinson. James Romig. Rachel Malfers. Colton Morris. It's not Diego. Hank Hamlin. Callen Goff. Nyrika Young. Janice Scott. Tyrese Oxendine. Sabrisha Glover. Anthony Scott. Nykira Scott. Anaya Reina Palmer. Anaya Lanice Hardy. Lisbeth Gonzalez. Yuri Arita. Jordan Jara. Elena Kishane Jenkins. Alexis Garcia.
My hands, buddy? It's hot out, man.
Daniel Thomas. Morgan Stoffler.
Don't say queer, that's
Angel Quiroz.
Members of the South Putnam community, we want to thank you so much again tonight for all of your ongoing support here at Crescent City High School and our mission to continuously improve our graduation rate. You see tonight, it works when you support us. Class of 2021, you are all ready to begin a new chapter in life. As I turn over the keys to Crescent City High School, to what will soon be Crescent City Junior Senior High School, to my dear friend, Mr. Tim Adams, I too will begin a new chapter in life. Colleges, careers, technical schools, and armed forces await each and every one of us. As we exit the field tonight, remember, Crescent City High School is no longer our everyday location, but it will always be our home. As we say, once a Raider, always a Raider. Always. I hear alumni up there. They know what to say. Let's say it one more time. Once a Raider,
always a Raider.
You know it's true. Do not fear your future, but embrace it. As challenges come your way, do not hide from them, but face them head on with grit and determination to overcome any and all obstacles. Never dwell on your failures, but always focus on your success. Live life to the fullest each and every day, knowing that you gave it your best shot. At this time, students, please stand and join me. Through the power entrusted me by the Florida Department of Education and the superintendent of the Putnam County School District, I decree that these students are the graduates of the class of 2021. By moving the tassel from the right to the left, you will signify that your completion of high school graduation requirements and the end of our ceremony. Students, on the count of three, you may move your tassel from the right to the left. One, two, three. Congratulations, class of 2021. Families. Our graduates still have one more celebration, so please wait until they've completed their last team activity before coming onto our field. This will be a great photo opportunity, I promise, so get your cameras ready. Ms. Jones, strike up the band.
Changed ever since we was on. I dreamed it all.
ever since I was young, they said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Congratulations. Worked so hard, forgot how to vacation. They